Hello students, welcome to Nelson School. Today we are going to learn about our environment and natural resources, that is chapter 13. So first of all, what is environment? Environment means anything that surrounds us. It can be living, biotic or non-living, abiotic things. The circumstances, objects or conditions by which one is surrounded is called environment. Here you can see in this picture also. Now, moving forward to pollution. What is pollution? What are the types of pollution? Pollution is the introduction of contaminants into the natural environment that cause adverse change. Pollution can take the form of chemical substances or energy, such as noise, heat or light. Now, there are mainly four types of pollution: air pollution, water pollution, soil pollution and noise pollution. So first of all, we will learn about what is air pollution. Here you can see in this picture also the pollution. Now, what is air pollution? Air pollution is the presence of substances in the atmosphere that are harmful to the health of humans and other living beings or cause damage to the climate or to materials. Now, what are the effects of air pollution? Respiratory infections, heart disease, lung cancer, breathing, wheezing, coughing, asthma. So these are the diseases which we get from air pollution. So in the end, we must not pollute the air. Now moving forward to another type of pollution, that is water pollution. Here you can see in this GIF also the air pollution and in this image also. Now, what is water pollution? Water pollution occurs when harmful substances, often chemicals or microorganisms, contaminate a stream, river, lake, ocean, aquifer or other body of water, degrading water quality and rendering it to toxic humans or the environment. Here you can see in this GIF also, this is water pollution, how the fish are dead now. Here you can see in this picture also. Now, what are the effects of water pollution? Typhoid, cholera, hepatitis and various other diseases. Hence, we must not pollute the water bodies also. Now, moving forward to soil or land pollution. What is soil pollution? Soil pollution is defined as the presence of toxic chemicals, pollutants or contaminants in soil in high enough concentrations to pose a risk to human health or the ecosystem. Here you can see in this GIF also, this is soil pollution. Now, what are the effects of soil pollution? Soil pollution can also cause neuromuscular blockage as well as depression of the central nervous system, headaches, nausea, fatigue, eye irritation and skin rash. Hence, we should not pollute the soil also. Now, moving forward to noise pollution. What is noise pollution? Here you can see this GIF also, the noise pollution. Now, noise pollution is generally defined as regular exposure to elevated sound levels that may lead to adverse effects in humans or other living organisms. Now, what are the effects which we get from noise pollution? Such as hearing problems, psychological issues, physical problems, cognitive issues and behavioral changes, sleeping disorders, trouble communicating. These are the effects which we get from noise pollution. Hence, we should not make noise pollution. Now, moving forward to greenhouse effect. What is greenhouse effect? The greenhouse effect is a process that occurs when gases in Earth's atmosphere trap the sun's heat. This process makes Earth much warmer than it would be without an atmosphere. Here you can see in this GIF also, this is greenhouse. Now, the greenhouse effect is one of the things that makes Earth a comfortable place to live. Greenhouse gases include water, vapor, carbon dioxide, methane, nitrous oxide, ozone and some artificial chemicals such as chlorofluorocarbons, that is CFCs. A greenhouse is a structure with walls and roof made chiefly of transparent material such as glass in which plants requiring regulated climatic conditions are grown. Here you can see in this picture also, this is greenhouse. Now, moving forward to global warming. What is global warming? Global warming is the unusually rapid increase in Earth's average surface temperature over the past century, primarily due to the greenhouse gases released by people burning fossil fuels. The globe is heating up. Both land and oceans are now warmer than they were ever before. Now you can see in this GIF also, this is global warming. Now moving forward to natural resources. What is natural resources? Natural resources are resources that exist without any actions of humankind. Natural resources are naturally occurring materials that are useful to man. Natural resources are usually either renewable or non-renewable. Now let us look at what are renewable resources. Renewable resources are the ones that can grow again. Trees are a good example. If cut down, they can regrow from seeds and sprouts. Animals are another example. Baby animals are born and grown up. They replace older animals that die. Air and water are renewable natural resources too. They don't regrow like trees or have babies like animals, but they are always being renewed. They move in cycles. They go from one place to another and often back where they started again and again. This is a good thing. There is another type of renewable natural resource. It includes sources of power like sun and wind energy. These are never ending. Finally, remember this. Renewable resources can regrow or be replaced within a person's lifespan. So here are some examples of renewable resources: solar energy, water, wind. Now, moving forward to non-renewable natural resources. First, look at the example of non-renewable resources. This is phosphate, oil, limestone. Now, they are found in the ground. There are fixed amounts of these resources. They are not living things and they are sometimes hard to find. They don't regrow and they are not replaced or renewed. They include the fossil fuels we burn for energy, natural gas, coal and oil. Minerals used for making metals are also non-renewable natural resources. Non-renewable natural resources are things that take longer than a person's lifespan to be replaced. In fact, they can take millions of years to form. This is non-renewable energy. Now moving forward to conservation of natural resources. Earth's natural resources include air, minerals, plants, soil, water, and wildlife. Conservation is the care and protection of these resources so that they can persist for future generations. The following are some tips on conserving natural resources: buying less stuff, reduce excess packaging, recycle materials such as metal cans, old cell phones and plastic bottles. Decrease the amount of paper you print. Throw trash in the trash can. Switch to non-plastic water bottles. Hence, by following these measures, we can conserve our natural resources. Thank you.